everybody, and welcome back to another video here on Rabbit IND. I know it's not Tuesday, and I said I was only going to upload on Tuesdays right now, but I had to make this video because you guys freaking smashed those views on the last video. Link will be at the end. You guys gave me 100 views in under 30 minutes. Now you might be thinking, Gary, what does this mean? This means I am now going to explain to you early why the cops showed up a few weeks late. Because you guys were so amazing on the views on that last video. Now the dislikes and the likes were about the same. That's okay. I'm cool with that. But just for you guys, here is the reason that the cops had came those few weeks later. Here in Africa. So, I don't remember what night it was. So let's just say it was a Friday night. I'm gonna say it was a Friday night. Me, my wife Nicole, and a bunch of our friends were going to meet at Africa, the spot that you saw in the video. Now we were planning on having a bonfire there, which we had many other times there before, so we didn't think it'd be a big deal. So we all meet up there. We all bring snacks and drink. We pull out the pallet to make the fire, and we start setting up. But then I remember that I didn't have enough gas to go home after we all hung out that night, and it was pretty late at night, so I didn't want to have to run out of gas on the side of the road at like 1 a.m. So I go to get gas. So I'm driving and I go to get gas and I come back and Nicole shoots me a text message and says, the cops are here, don't come back. So I start freaking out. Now the cops are at the place where we're all hanging out, and you know me, I mean, I am no criminal, but they ain't getting me. Being the good husband that I am, I'm like, yo babe, I'm coming to get you. He insisted that she stay there and that I don't come back because she didn't want me to get in trouble. I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know if they were going to arrest my friends or possibly my wife. So I had to come up with a plan. I didn't really come up with anything because I didn't have any idea what to do because I didn't want to get in trouble with the cops. They take all their fingerprints. They take pictures of their feet, which is a little weird because I don't know why the cops would need to take pictures of your feet. And they get all their names, and I wait for them all to get to a restaurant afterwards to basically meet them there because I had nowhere else to go while they were all stuck there. So we get to the restaurant, and they all tell me that apparently some guy owns all that. How can somebody have owned that for the entire time that everybody's been going there and nobody knows anything? It's not like there's a no trespassing sign that says, please don't come here, please don't mud here, please don't ride your dirt bikes here, please don't hang out here. But whatever, the guy apparently had been throwing a temper tantrum and the cops were just there to finally put an end to it, to basically make the old man happy and get the kids off his property. Nobody got arrested, which is a plus. Unfortunately, the night had to be cut short, but it was still a pretty funny and scary experience for me and my friends. So they all got mad at me because, once again, I escaped the police officers. There you have it, guys. That is why we cannot go back there. Really hope you guys enjoyed that. I thank you guys again for that super amazing amount of views. I mean, I'm 3 videos in back to this YouTube channel and you guys already hit me with a 100 view video. That's amazing, guys. I really appreciate it and I love you guys. If you really like this video, feel free to give it a like and subscribe for more videos because I love having you guys like making videos for you guys. You guys have a really great day and I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay rabbit. Yeah. We'll be right back.